Hello students, now we will begin the next kingdom, that is Protista. So far we have discussed about kingdom Monera, their general characters we have discussed in the previous video. Now we will begin Protista. As already we have understood what kind of organisms are included under kingdom Protista. Okay, so some of the general features they have written. You can note down these points. These are the general features. We shall discuss them in detail. First of all, this group is characterized by what? Kingdom Protista is characterized by their unicellular form, made up of, their body is made up of single cell, and they are having advanced type of nucleus, means they are unicellular and having advanced type of nucleus. This is the main feature of the kingdom Protista. Okay, so eukaryotic means having advanced type of nucleus. Now second character, so this group includes different kinds of examples. So with examples we will discuss them. This group includes the group called as chrysophyte. See, so what kind of members are included under chrysophytes? We will be discussing them. Next, dinoflagellates, euglenoids, slime molds, protozoa. Okay, so first we shall see what are chrysophytes. Okay, so what is the meaning of chrysophytes? So here it includes especially the single celled algae. Okay, chrysophytes are nothing but some diatoms and golden algae, they are included under this group. Okay, chrysophytes means those examples are diatoms. And in addition to that, dinoflagellates also are included here. So having flagella and their aquatic marine form, and then euglenoids. So euglenoids, this group composed of a euglena, so having a single cell having one flagella as a locomotory organ. In addition to that, slime molds. So what are slime molds? What are slime molds? Slime molds are nothing but they are also eukaryotic cells, and either these organisms can live freely or they can survive, or sometimes they may aggregate together to form multicellular organisms. So slime molds may be either single cellular or they may be multicellular. If they are aggregated, they form a group of aggregation form slime molds, multicellular slime molds. And then last comes the protozoa, primitive organisms. Especially proto refers to primitive, zoa means animals. So the primitive animals are included under protozoa. So these are the different classification or groups included under kingdom Protista. So kingdom Protista includes four groups: chrysophytes, dinoflagellates. Sorry, five groups are there: chrysophytes, the dinoflagellate, euglenoid, slime molds, protozoa. So the detailed general features of all these groups we are going to discuss later on. Okay, but now we will discuss some more important features of this group. Usually this group also having a well-defined nucleus. So they show well-defined nucleus. Hence they are called as eukaryotes. Hence they are called eukaryotes. And apart from that, these organisms, this group also contains, the cell contains cell organelles. Cell organelles like mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum, ribosomes, lysosomes. Okay, so all the cell organelles are found in this. Because why? Because they are advanced type of cells. They contain well defined nucleus and cell organelles. Membrane bounded structures are found here, and they also reproduce by sexually as well as asexually. So advanced type of reproduction they are carrying, that is sexual reproduction, that is by means of formation of gametes. And asexually means asexual reproductive bodies are formed, that is either by spore formation or by bud formation. So that's especially the spore formation. It is a type of a sexual reproduction. Now we will move towards the first group of the kingdom Protista. So here some of the features of kingdom Protista, that is Chrysophyta, we are going to discuss. So this group includes especially the diatoms. Here one question arises here. What is that? Diatom means what? Diatoms are nothing but they are single celled algae. They are algal members and they are unicellular. They are single celled members. And they are also known as golden algae. Why they are called golden algae? Because of the presence of a pigment. They have a predominant pigment, golden color pigment, that is fucoxanthin. So because of the presence of pigment fucoxanthin, they are called as golden algae, or otherwise they are also known as desmids. Golden algae are desmids. And what, where they occur, where the chrysophytes members are occurring or diatoms are occurring, they are found both in freshwater as well as marine water. So the freshwater example is that is river water and pond water, river water. And marine water means sea or ocean water. And usually they form a planktons. What is the meaning of plankton? These are the freely floating algal members. The freely floating algal members are known as planktons. Remember, this is a very important term. The keywords I have underlined. The keywords I have underlined, you can go through all the keywords. Underlined with the red pen. Okay. Planktons are freely floating algal members. And these algal members are carrying photosynthesis. They are photosynthetic in function because they contain a pigment. The pigment is present, hence they can photosynthesize. With reference to the cell wall, the diatoms possess well developed cell wall. So here cell wall is somewhat peculiar. Why? The diatoms are possessing cell wall, but their cell wall composition is silica. So the glassy appearance, shiny appearance, it is shiny in its appearance. Silica is found on the cell wall of the diatoms. Okay, and they form the cell wall just like a soap case. They are overlapped with each other. So one cell wall is overlapped with the upper as well as lower. Then they are overlapped with each other, forming a structure called a soap case box like structure, overlapping shape. Okay. So diatoms are mainly characterized by the presence of silica on their cell wall. And then there is one more term called as diatoms earth. Then what is diatom? So the diatom earth is nothing but the cell wall of the dead diatoms. The cell wall of the diatom, it is deposited on the oceanic bed. The cell wall of these members deposited in the oceanic earth over billions of years, and it is going to deposit and it forms a diatominous earth. So diatominous earth is a title given to the members called diatoms or chrysophytes. Next, last and final, there is one economic importance of the diatom. So diatoms are having high economic importance because of the presence of silica in their cell wall. They are found in, they are used in different field. So they are used for polishing material. In the polishing material, the diatoms are used. In the filtration of oils also they are used. And even as an insulating material. See, they are also used as an insulating material on the roads. So what are insulators? So insulators are the, they do not allow the heat to pass through them. So they are called as insulator. So they are used as an insulating material on the, as a road paints. They are used as a road paints, as an insulating material. They are used in the paints. So these are the some of the economic importance of a diatom. So with this chrysophytes, we have finished. We will stop here.